911事件之后，美国迅速锁定恐袭幕后主谋，但在美国的穆斯林从此就生活在敌意与歧视的阴影中。在纽约市布鲁克林区出生长大的哈尼夫，他是穆斯林，九岁那年发生了911事件，对当年还是小孩的他来说是个无法抹灭的阴影。
After 9/11, an immediate recollection is being called a terrorist. As a 9-year-old with my sister, as we were walking to the mosque across the street, and that has stayed in my body. And it's trauma that I'm holding. And so I recognize that young people who grew up or have a vivid memory of 9/11, need support.
这样的言语，这样的场景，更加鼓励哈尼夫竞选公职，让美国人了解穆斯林群体。而曼苏尔·沙姆斯想要融入美国社会，加入海军陆战队。如果不是发生不愉快的歧视事件，他从没想过退伍，离开部队。现在的他在为清真寺筹办活动碰上这么一件事，他也没想过会这样脱口而出说出一句令他醒思的话。
Recently, I was helping planning a trip for our Sunday school children to Niagara Falls, and I'm helping with the accommodation part of it. And when they said who's coming, I was like a house of worship. You know, this is so sad, right? Because I was like, maybe they'll treat me different. Maybe they're like, we don't want them coming here. I don't know, you know? And this is 20 years after 9/11 that I'm still having to feel this way. So we haven't made much progress, right? I mean, I can't call that progress.
20年过去，歧视和敌意从未消失，又何来社会的进步呢？在美国的穆斯林，他们身上的符号标志被无限放大。今年才刚上大学的阿米拉走过对自己信仰的认同，日常生活中她都戴着头巾 hijab。
I felt like empowered to take that step towards wearing hijab, not only as a step towards my own faith, my own iman, but as kind of to I want to take that step.To represent my faith in that specific time where Muslims were kind of on the spot.
头上包着头巾，蓄留着胡子，是锡克教男子典型的形象。而这样的形象让在美国的泰伯觉得自己很特别，甚至特别到总是被排除在外。
I was an angry child. You know, I was confused as to, you know, why I was born and raised here. So why is it that folks feel like, you know, why are they singling me out?
冒出滚滚浓烟的世贸中心双子星大楼倒塌后满布尘土的纽约市，或许就在911事件之后，美国的自由民主价值就此蒙上灰。想要再次走出偏见歧视的阴霾，或许还要经过好几代人才能重见光明。